Hello friends, welcome to NIOS, and in this video we are going to discuss about metric system of measurement, and I am Dr. Haneet Gandhi. There are many standard ways of measuring. Different countries have adopted different measurement systems, but the most common and widely used is the metric system of measurement. By the way, in our country, we also follow the metric system of measurement. In this video, our objective would be to study the metric system of measurement and how we use it in terms of length, weight, and volume. We will also learn to do some conversions in the metric system. If you are ready, I would recommend you also grab a pen and a pencil in front of you, because we would be doing certain arithmetic also. So take a minute, pause your video and grab hold a pen and a paper, because we would be doing little arithmetic in this video as well. If you're ready, let's begin. Let me first introduce you to the metric system. Metric system is used especially in terms of medicine, scientific, technical fields. They all depend on these metric systems. In most of the other countries, the metric system is the primary system of measurement. In India, we use metric system to measure things. So when we talk about kilograms, liter, meters, centimeter, etc., you must know that we are talking in terms of the metric system. However, if you ever wish to travel abroad, you would see that they do not use these terms as kilogram, liters, meters, and centimeter. Often you would see people using words like kilomiles, or miles, or ounces, or quarts. This is their unit of representing length, volume, area, so on. But in India, we use metric system, so we are going to discuss more on this. Basic units of a metric system. In a metric system, the basic unit of length is meter. And if I have to give you a short idea of what a meter is, you can take up as a yardstick, which is just over 3 feet tall. So if you place your foot 3 feet one to one, edge to edge, that's roughly about will give you a 1 meter. Similarly, the basic metric unit of mass is grams. If I have to give you an idea of a gram, pick up your paper clip. That's about 1 gram. Similarly, the basic metric unit of volume is liter. If I have to give you an idea of liter, pick up your standard water-shaped bottle. It would contain approximately 1 liter of water. So, what we need to understand while looking at metric system is, first we need to identify these basic units. Let me reiterate with you to revise. The basic unit of length is meter. The basic unit of mass or weight is gram. The basic unit of volume is a liter. Whatever we would be doing today would revolve around these three aspects of meter, grams, and liter. So, what are the foundational ideas of a metric system? Metric system is based on the base of 10, which means that within the system, to get larger or smaller units, we would use the powers of 10. We would either multiply or divide by powers of 10. If I have to explain it further, this would mean that a meter is 100 times larger than a centimeter, and a kilogram is 1000 times heavier than a gram. Similarly, a liter is 10 times larger than a deciliter, or a centigram is 10 times larger than a milligram. What you need to notice till now is I'm only doing powers of 10. I'm saying 100, 1000, 10 times, 10 times larger, 10 times smaller, all in terms of powers of 10. That's what I mean by when we say that the metric system is based on the base of 10. We are going to explore all these ideas a bit later. So, if I have to convert milliliters to liters, 1 millimeter is equal to 1 upon 1000 liter, which means to convert milliliters to liters, we have to divide the number of milliliters by 1,000. 1,000. The example below, we're just doing that. If I have 45 milliliters and I wish to tell somebody how much liter do I have, I need to divide 45 by 1,000. And if you do a little bit of arithmetic, you would understand that that would come out to be 0.045 liters. In other words, our 45 milliliter is equal to 0.045 liters. So, we will explore all these ideas a bit later. The names of metric units are formed by adding prefix to the basic unit of measurement. To tell you how large or small a unit is, you need to look at the prefix. Prefix is the little symbol that would be placed before our unit, which means to tell whether the unit is measuring length, mass, or volume, you should first look at its base. Look at this table very, very carefully. You would find that this has 7 columns and the middle column is our basic unit. Meter for length, gram for weight, and volume, liter for volume. Left and right to it are multiples of 10 going lower or above. So if I have to say kilometer or kilogram or kiloliter, it would mean 1,000 times larger than the base unit. In other words, a kilometer is 1,000 times larger than the meter. A kilogram is 1,000 times larger than the gram. A kiloliter similarly is 1,000 times larger than the liter. Going to the other side are the milliliters, which are 1,000 times smaller than the base unit. Similarly, I can say 1 milliliter is 1,000 times smaller than the liter. 1 milliliter is 1,000 times smaller than the meter. Or 1 milligram is 1,000 times smaller than the gram. Notice how these prefixes I've used in terms of the base unit. A hecto similarly is 100 times larger than the base unit. A deca is 10 times larger than the base unit. A deci is 10 times smaller. It's on the other side. A centi is 100 times smaller than the base unit. And since centimeter is the most commonly used unit of measurement, we often use it in terms of meter. And this you would be familiar with, that 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. We are going to use this table in this entire video. So you might need to relook at it again. Please be careful in how these conversions are done. Children can be helped to learn some abbreviations of four related standard units, such as the meaning of kilo, centi, and milli. Let them observe that since gram is the basic unit of measuring weight, all other units are created by prefixing gram. The prefixes represent multiples of the unit, which means kilo means 1,000 times the basic unit, and centi would tell us 100 times of the basic unit, and milli would be 1 upon 1,000 times of the basic unit. Using the table as a reference, you can see the following. I'm saying this again because this needs to be done very, very carefully with children. 1 kilogram is 1,000 times the larger than 1 gram. So 1 kilometer in terms of mathematical equations can be written as 1 kg is equal to 1,000 grams. A centimeter is 100 times smaller than a meter. So 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. A decaliter is 10 times larger than the liter. So a decaliter is equal to 10 liters. In the next video, we're going to see how we do these conversions up and down in the metric scale. Converting between metric units of measure requires the knowledge of metric prefixes and an understanding of the decimal system. By using the table, you can figure out how many centigrams are there in 1 decagram. Each unit is 10 times larger then its immediate one on the right. This means that one decagram is 10 grams. 10 grams is 100 decigrams. And 100 decigrams is equal to 1000 centigrams. So one decagram, I can say, is 1000 centigrams, isn't it? We're going to use all these in our measuring units. So the measuring system for measuring, metric system for measuring length. Meter is the basic unit for measuring length. All other units are created by prefixing meter. The prefixes represent multiples of tens of the unit. Children can be helped to learn some abbreviations for standard units, such as kilo, centi, and milli. So, kilo means 1000 times the basic unit. Centi tells us that it is 100 of the basic unit, and milli implies 1000th of a basic unit. We are going to use this understanding to do some small conversions. Remember this length of conversions as well. 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. 1 hectometer is equal to 100 meter. 1 decameter is equal to 10 meter. 1 decimeter is equal to 0.1 meter or 1 upon 10 meter or 1/10 of a meter. 1 centimeter is equal to 0.01 meter or 1 upon 100 meter or 1/100 of a meter. 1 millimeter is equal to 0.001 meter or 1000th of a meter. Let's do a little example. So to convert larger units to smaller units, we multiply the number of larger units by the converting factor and the appropriate smaller unit. For example, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. So if I want to know how many would 11 meters come up in centimeters, I would multiply 11 by 100 centimeters, which means 11 meters is equal to 11 into 100 centimeters, which would come out to be 1100 centimeters. Similarly, to convert smaller units to larger units, we need to divide the number of smaller units by their converging factor. 1 millimeter is equal to 10 centimeter. So if I want to convert centimeter to meter, I will divide by 100. If I need to convert 1 meter into kilometer, I will divide by 1000. Take this example. When I've converted meters to kilometers, 1 meter, recall, is equal to 1 upon 1000 kilometer or 1000th kilometer, which means 7 meters would be 7 times 1 upon 1000 kilometers or 7 divided by 1000, which is equal to 0.007 kilometers. It's the same idea is used to measure weight as well. In the metric system, the unit to measure weight is kilograms. The idea of a kilogram was invented by connecting it to volume and length. A liter of water, when kept in 1 cubic decimeter of volume, weighs 1000th gram or 1 kilogram of weight. Thus, the basic metric unit of measuring weight was invented in terms of liters and cubic volume. For a quick reference to know how much a kilogram weighs, pick a commonly used 1 liter water bottle. This bottle weighs approximately 1 kilogram, and bottled weight minus the empty bottle will help you to get an understanding of how much a kilogram would weigh. Nevertheless, coming on to our metric conversions, children can be helped to learn some abbreviations of standard unit again, as kilograms, centigrams, milligrams, so on and so forth. Gram, the basic unit, will be used in all these conversions by using prefixes. Important table: 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 grams, 1 hectogram is equal to 100 grams, 1 decagram is equal to 10 grams, 1 decigram is equal to 0.1 gram or 1/10 of a gram, 1 centigram is equal to 1/100 of a gram or 0.01 grams, 1 milligram is equal to 0.001 gram or 1,000th of a gram. We're going to use this for our conversions. So if we need to convert kilograms to grams, you need to know that 1 kilogram is equal to 1,000 grams. So if you need to know the weight of kilograms, 8 kilograms in terms of grams, you need to multiply 8 with 1,000. 8 kilograms would thus be 8 multiplied by 1,000 or 8,000 grams. Similarly, if you need to convert grams to kilograms, you need to divide by 1,000 because 1 gram is equal to 1,000th of a kilogram. So if you need to know the weight of 9 grams in terms of kilograms, it would be 9 times 1 upon 1,000th kilograms, or 9 divided by 1,000, which is equal to 0.009 grams. Let's now look at the metric system for measuring volume. Recall that in the metric system for measurement of volume, the most common units of volume are milliliters or liters. We often talk in terms of liters, 1 liter of a bottle, 20 liters of a bucket, or milliliters when we are measuring very small quantities, such as 1 tablespoon, 1 teaspoon. These are mentioned in milliliters. Converting liters to milliliters follow the same rule. 1 liter is equal to 1,000 milliliters. So to convert liters to milliliters, you would multiply the number of liters with 1,000. As just shown in the example, 8 liters would be equal to 8 times 1,000, or 8 multiplied by 1,000, which gives us 8,000 milliliters. And converting milliliters to liters, you need to divide by 1,000, or 1 milliliter is equal to 1 upon 1,000 liter. So to convert milliliters to liters, we divide by the number of milliliters by 1,000. For example, if you need to know 45 milliliters in terms of liters, divide 45 by 1,000. 45 milliliters would be 45 divided by 1,000, which is equal to 0.045 liters. I hope all these conversions would have helped you to get an idea of what we do in metric system. Your basic arithmetic needs to be clarified before doing these calculations, and then move on to adding, converting meters, and then adding these measurements. I hope these videos would have clarified the idea of measurement clearly in your mind. Use them into your classroom and have a good room. Thank you.